Good afternoon. Today is the vigil of the 24th Sunday of Ordinary Time. It's also September 12th, which is the feast day of the Holy Name of Mary. Let us begin the rosary in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the living and the dead. Virtues of faith, hope, and charity, for our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for all the holy souls in purgatory, for all the firefighters and people who are affected by these fires, and also for our children who are coming back to school, and for your special intentions. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou.
Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. O my Jesus, forgive us our sins, save us from the fires of hell, and lead our souls to heaven, especially those most in need of thy mercy. Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee we cry, for many children of thee. To thee we send our sight. O Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Thank you. thought of your God, creator and ruler of all things, that we may know the working of your mercy, grant that we may serve you with all our heart. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of Sirach. Rather than anger are hateful things, yet the sinner hugs them tight. The vengeful will suffer the Lord's vengeance, for the remembrance their sins in detail. Forgive your neighbor's justice, injustice. Then when you pray, your own sins will be forgiven. Could anyone nourish anger against another and accept healing from the Lord? Could anyone refuse mercy to another like himself? Can he seek pardon for his own sins? If one who is but flesh charges worth, you will forgive his sins. Remember your last days, set enmity aside. Remember death and decay, and cease from sin. Think of the commandments, hate not your neighbor. Remember the Most High's covenant, and overlook faults. The word of the Lord. The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger, and rich in compassion. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all my being. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger, and rich in compassion.
He pardons all your iniquities, heals all your ills, redeems your life from destruction. He crowns you with kindness and compassion.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger, rich in compassion.
He will not always tire, nor does he keep his word forever. Not according to our sins does he deal with us, nor does he requite us according to our crimes. From as the heavens are high above the earth, so surpassing is his kindness toward those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as he put our transgressions from us.
The Lord is kind and merciful, slow to anger, rich in compassion.
Second reading. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, none of us lives for oneself, and no one dies for ourselves. For if we live, we live for the Lord, and if we die, we die for the Lord. So then, whether we live or die, we are the Lord's. For this is why Christ died and came to life, that he might be Lord for both the dead and the living. The word of the Lord.
Alleluia.
Love one another as
not seven times, but 77 times. That is why the kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who decided to sell a house for his servants. When the end had come, a debtor was brought before him, who owed him a huge amount. Since he had no way of paying it back, his master ordered him to be sold, along with his wife, his children, and all his property, in payment of the debt. That the servant fell down, bid him how much, and said, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back in full." Moved with compassion, the master of that servant let him go, and forgave him the loan. When that servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him a much smaller amount. He seized him, started to choke, demanded, "Pay back what you owe." Falling to his knees, his fellow servant begged him, "Be patient with me, and I will pay you back." But he refused. Instead, he had the fellow servant put in prison until he paid back the debt. Now, when his fellow servant saw what had happened, they were deeply disturbed, went to the master, and reported the whole affair. His master summoned him and said to him, "You wicked servant, I forgive you your debt entirely because you paid me so much. Should you not have had pity on your fellow servant as I have pity on you?" Then in anger, his master handed him over to the torturers, but he should pay back the whole debt. So will my heavenly Father do with you, unless each of you forgives your brother from your own. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Today's Gospel of David is using 77 numbers. The same amount of times which is good is far greater than we can get. For the true bottle of Jesus, there is no limit to how many times and how much we forgive. As disciples of the Lord, we realize the great mercy we have received from God. He sent his Son to become one of us, share life with us. He died so that we might have eternal life. The Christian understands that next to the forgiveness we have received from God, there can be no limit for the forgiveness of the forgiveness that we extend to others. I want to illustrate this with a story. October 2nd, 2006, a shooting occurred in the Amish One Room Schoolhouse, the Amish Community Community, in Hickamaya, a small town to the left of Pennsylvania. The gunman, Charles Carl Adams, a married man with three children. No one knows why he did what he did. They know what happened. Robert pulled his pickup truck up to the school and asked the teacher if she or any of the children had seen something that he said he lost in the world. Can you hear me better now?
Yep.
Well, I can tell a funny story about the children from the English community in 2006. Gunmen went into the school, sent the boys out of school. They kept the girls there. And then began shooting. Killed five and maybe three. Grandfather told younger relatives not to get angry, not to call people in their hearts. And others said, this man is now standing before God. This man has suffered, and God will take care of him. Thank you, Sister. It's a reminder that we are to. It's a reminder that we are to try to act with forgiveness toward others, hoping never suffering some tragedy. Mary Roberts, the widow of the killer, wrote an open letter to her Amy's neighbors, thanking them for their forgiveness, the grace and mercy that they had shown her. She wrote, your love for our family has helped to provide healing for us that we so desperately needed. The gifts you have given touched our hearts in a way no words can describe. Your compassion has reached beyond our community. Beyond, it has reached out into the world. And for this, we sincerely thank you. Forgiveness and renewing forgiveness brings healing. Forgiveness brings the mercy of God. Holding on to anger only causes more suffering within the person who is holding on to it, perhaps also the person who has done the wrong. In the Gospel, the first servant, parable, has this huge debt, and as the owner or the master calls him to pay it off, he asks for mercy, and he gives him that mercy. It's a debt that's almost impossible to imagine. 15,000 years of working. We need to pay it off, and came to his servant. But then the same servant goes out and meets someone who owes him about 100 days of pay. And he throttles the person, he throws him into jail until he can pay back the debt. He hadn't heard from his master. Hadn't followed the example of the master who, in a way, sets a tone for all of his servants. And so the master reacts by calling him back in. Placing him in jail. It's obvious that in the parable, Jesus is saying, we are like that first servant. We have offended God, and God readily forgives us. And we know in our own lives that people have offended us. They, in a sense, are like that second servant, a kind of minor error. And yet, oftentimes we are hesitant to forgive them and bring peace into their lives. Jesus is calling us to be people who are generous with mercy and forgiveness because we follow the example of Jesus and of our Heavenly Father. Sometimes people will say, I can't forgive and forget. I'll never forget what he or she did to my family. Forgetting might not be possible. The families in that Amish community now celebrating 16 years since that happened. Certainly haven't forgotten them, but they are able to renew that forgiveness. And perhaps sometimes when they recall what happened, there's that sense of hatred, bitterness, or resentment. But they're a very Christian community. They support one another, and they turn back to prayer, trusting in God as they ask God to forgive that man, to bless his family. And they are renewing that gift of peace that God will share with them. Our gift of forgiveness is not just for the person who has done wrong to us. In a way, it's a gift to ourselves also. As the Lord comes, freeing us from that hatred, that resentment, that guilt, that anger, renewing us, it's a way of putting our life back on track. Mercy, action of his master, should have touched his heart, made him a different person. It didn't. The generous example of the master should have guided him to imitate the master who read to those underneath him as the master who created him. The Lord is uniting us today in the ceremony. How generous he has been to each one of us, and calls us to be generous also. We are to act differently than them serving. As we pray the Our Father prayer, forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Perhaps difficult words to say and put into practice, but they open our heart to receive that peace that the Lord will share with us as we shall be sharing that peace with others. We might not want to forgive, but the pain that we receive from others is mine. Such a glory of God's mercy and God's heaven that He is here to share with us. We might pause in all that we receive. We might look at the material gifts we have. We might look at the spiritual gifts we have. And we know God. We know His great love. We can come to Jesus with confidence. God has truly blessed us and calls us to bless others. Today we pray for the grace to forgive, to move on with life. We thank the Lord for the innumerable times He has forgiven us in the past, and as He comforts us now, especially in those moments when we struggle to be forgiving to one another.
Stand and pray the creed. I believe.
Let the church serve as a beacon of reconciliation, leading others in the ways of harmony. pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The nations locked in disagreement, break the nation's bond of the hatred and seek healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who worship the God of Abraham, Jews, Muslims, and Christians, foster peace in the world through mutual forgiveness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all who are burdened by the weight of resentment find solace in today's lessons and compassion and forgiveness. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the members of this assembly mirrors God's mercy in the way they care for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
hear our prayer. For all those who have died, that they may enjoy the fullness of God's heavenly glory. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. We offer now our personal intentions for these and all the prayers enter in our book of prayer, and those that are held in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God of forgiveness and peace, listen to the prayers of your people. Where there is hatred, inspire us to sow love. Where there is anger, help us pardon. Form us in the image of your Son, the Prince of Peace, through whom we make our prayer, through the Lord, forever and ever.
Amen.
by sending that which we have come to the people of God, so that they may become for us the body of God by our Lord Jesus Christ. In the time he was prepared, they were willing to his passion, which was prayer, giving thanks for him, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all believe in me. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of God." Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray,